Hello students, today's session is all about SS Chapter 3 Cultural Heritage of India, Sculpture and Architecture. From the previous chapters, we have come to know about the cultural heritage of India. We know that Indian civilization had an important place among the contemporary civilizations of the world like Egyptian civilization, Mesopotamian civilization, etc. In this chapter, we are going to discuss the contribution of ancient India in the field of sculpture and architecture. What is sculpture? Sculpture is an art of making designs or statues on stones, wood or metals with the help of hammer and chisel. So it is a very ancient art of India that was developed here around 5000 years ago. Many statues, idols, etc. were carved on stones, metals, wood, etc. by this art. So ancient India had contributed a lot in the field of sculpture. What is architecture? The simple meaning of architecture is construction. The art or practice of designing and constructing buildings, that is called architecture. The word vastu is used for architecture in Sanskrit language. And you know, today the science of architecture or vastu shastra is being adopted even by the foreigners. Ancient town planning. The remains of ancient town planning have been found out from many places in India during the excavation work done at these places. From all this excavation, we come to know that all these towns were divided into three sections: fort of rulers, houses of administrative officers on the upper part of the town, and residences of common people on the lower part of the town. So this is a common feature that was found in almost all the towns that were excavated from India. Fort of rulers were constructed on the upper part of the town, and upper part of the town is safe and protected with houses having 2 to 5 rooms. Houses on the lower part of the town are mainly constructed with handmade bricks, and the common people were living in this lower part. Of all these towns excavated from India, Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, these two are considered as the best town planning. So Mohenjo-daro was discovered in the year 1922 by the Indian archaeologists named Rakhaldas Banerjee and Dayaram Sani. They did the excavation work at Mohenjo-daro under the guidance of Sir John Marshall and Colonel Meek. Mohenjo-daro was situated in Larkhan district. Today it is in Pakistan. The meaning of Mohenjo-daro is the heap of deads. The whole town of Mohenjo-daro had 5 divisions, that is construction of town or municipal composition. Here, the houses were built on high plinth in order to protect them from floods and dampness. And the houses of rich people were double storied and they had 5 to 7 rooms, okay? Whereas the poor people were living in single storied houses which had 2 to 3 rooms. And the whole town was fortified. That means a strong wall was constructed around the whole town. Then the main entrance of the houses that were opened on the side lanes and not on the main roads. Then the houses had all the facilities like storehouse, kitchen, bathrooms, storehouses. All these were there in houses in Mohenjo-daro. So there was also a proper arrangement of doors and windows in order to keep the houses airy and ventilated. The second division is roads. Roads are the main feature of Mohenjo-daro. They were very wide, having 9.75 meter width, and many vehicles could pass at the same time. Then pits on the roadside suggest that they might have been used for erecting lamp posts. We know that no electricity was there during that time, so lamp posts were there. There were two main roads. One was in the north-south direction and the other road was in the east-west direction. And both these main roads crossed at right angles, okay? There were many other small link roads also connecting these main roads, and all the roads were straight without any turns. Next is drainage system. So drainage system is a unique feature of Mohenjo-daro town planning. The town had an underground drainage system. Dirty water from the house was drained into a large gutter through a small drain pipe. And from these large gutters, it was disposed out of the town through main pipes. Okay, there was a cesspit in every house where the dirty water was collected. And when the cesspit was filled, the excess water automatically flowed into the Main gutter through pipeline. Similar kind of drainage system was also found in the island of Crete, which is in the Mediterranean Sea. So from this underground drainage system, we can understand that the people of Mohenjo-Daro, they were very much conscious about their health and hygiene. Now the fourth division is public bath. A huge public bath was excavated at Mohenjo-Daro. There was an arrangement to put fresh water in and dirty water out of this bath. And there might have been facility for hot water and small rooms for changing the clothes. On the periphery of the great bath, small rooms were there for changing clothes. These public baths might have been used especially on the occasion of festivals and religious ceremonies. The last division is public buildings. The ruins of two huge buildings have been found at Mohenjo-Daro, and we don't know exactly for what purpose they might have been using these buildings, but archaeologists believe that they might have been used as a town hall or as a theater or an administrative office or a granary. And also a barrack of such buildings also found from Mohenjo-Daro, and this group of buildings might have been used to accommodate soldiers. You can see the image of Mohenjo-Daro town planning here and the great bath that was excavated from Mohenjo-Daro. Now we learn about Harappa. The Harappa town planning was the most systematic town planning. The houses with all facilities like kitchen, storehouses, then many forts also excavated from this place. This culture was developed in the region of Sapta Sindhu, where many rivers, including River Indus, were flowing. So we know the culture which was developed on the bank of River Indus was called as Indus Valley Civilization. So this Indus Valley Civilization is also known as Harappan Civilization, because the remains of Indus Valley Civilization was first found from the place Harappa. That is why it has got another name, Harappan Civilization. Then one more fact about this place was that many copper and stone weapons and many other things were also found out from this place. So Harappan Civilization is also called as Copper Stone Age. The people of Harappa were also very fond of wearing ornaments. Now we are going to learn the remains of Indus Valley Civilization were found from many places in India, like Rapar in Himalayan region, Alamgirpur at Meerut in Uttar Pradesh, Kalibangan in Rajasthan, Lothal at Dholka in Gujarat, Deshalpur Shikharpur in Kutch, Dholavira, Rangpur near Limdi in Saurashtra, Srinathgarh near Gondal, Kundasi near Morbi, Somnath. So these were the places from where the civilizations contemporary to Indus Valley Civilization was excavated. You can see here in the map places where contemporary to Indus Valley Civilization was existing in all these places. Now we learn about Dholavira. Dholavira town, which was contemporary to Harappan Civilization, is located at Khadirbet of Bachau Taluka in Kutch district. A special task of excavation work was done at Dholavira by the Archaeological Department of India in the year 1990 under the leadership of Ravindra Singh Bisht. The remains of houses, palaces, fortifying walls, etc. were found from Dholavira. And the walls of palaces and the fortifying walls were painted with white color. The strong walls around the town shows their consciousness about their security. In Dholavira, there was also the facility of providing drinking water, as well as the water purification system was also there. From all these remains of Dholavira, we can understand that it was a huge, systematic and a developed town planning in India. These are some of the images from Dholavira. Now we learn about Lothal. Lothal is situated in Dholka Taluka of Ahmedabad district. Dholka is a place which is situated between two rivers, Bhogavo and Sabarmati, and it is 18 km far from Bay of Kamba. And from Lothal, you know, three layers of human habitation were found. The three layers means what? Fort of rulers, upper part of the administrative officials, the lower part of the common people. Thus, the three layers of human habitation were found even from Lothal also. The main feature of Lothal was that there was dockyard and granaries. Granaries means storage houses. And all these dockyard and storage houses suggest that Lothal was an important center of trade and commerce. Export and import was undertaken through this port of Lothal. Hence, we come to a conclusion that Lothal might have been a very rich and a prosperous port of India. Hope that all these topics are clear to you. Please read your textbook thoroughly for a proper understanding. Now, the remaining topics of the chapter will be continued in the next session. Until then, take care. Bye.